I'm Gregory B. Poindexter, Associate Editor for Hydro Review and Hydro Review Worldwide. Welcome to this edition of Worldwide Hydro Headlines. There is controversy in Canada surrounding the Site C hydroelectric project. For more than 50 years, BC Hydro has built its major projects using labor agreements that ensured no strikes and no lockouts. Non-unionized contracts could bid on the work, but workers had to belong to one of the building trade unions. But a new model was proposed for Site C, consisting of an open shop format under which contractors would be able to bring in non-union workers and the unions would be prohibited from organizing those workers or trying to get them to join unionized projects. BC Hydro said this new arrangement would promote stability in the workforce and give contractors access to the largest pool of skilled and experienced workers. But on March 3rd, British Columbia Prime Minister Christy Clark instructed Jessica McDonald, the executive officer of BC Hydro, to change the contract terms for the 1,100 megawatt Site C hydro project to allow unions to organize at the construction site. This intervention comes shortly after the BC and Yukon Territory Building and Construction Trade Councils filed a lawsuit against BC Hydro to stop BC Hydro from employing non-unionized workers at Site C. Construction for the Canadian $8.8 billion project located on the Peace River is expected to begin in the summer 2015. It will provide about 10,000 direct construction jobs. The province of British Columbia approved the Site C Clean Energy Project in December 2014, concluding it will provide BC with the most affordable, reliable, clean power for more than 100 years. On the African continent in Uganda, Sinohydro has awarded Alstom a U.S. $65 million contract to provide equipment and technical services for Uganda's 600-megawatt Karuma hydropower project. The Karuma project is located on the Victoria Nile River in Kiriadongo and Oyem districts about 15 kilometers downstream of Karuma Falls. Alstom will provide six 100-megawatt Francis turbine generator sets and related equipment. Alstom Hydro China is responsible for design, manufacture, and supervision in installation, commissioning, and testing. Work on the U.S. $2 billion plant stalled in June 2013 due to a lack of funds before China provided a U.S. $500 million credit. Now, once it is completed, Karuma will be the largest power plant in Uganda, and it will provide about 50% of the country's energy. In Asia, Oceania, Pakistan's Environmental Protection Agency announced that it has awarded a U.S. $1.4 billion contract to a group of Pakistani and Chinese investors that includes China Three Gorges South Asia Investment Limited. The group will develop the 720-megawatt Karo hydroelectric project on the Jhelum River in the Rawalpindi district of Pakistan. 93% of the project's funding is through China Three Gorges, and the remaining 7% is from Pakistan-based Associated Technologies Private Limited. The National Transmission and Dispatch Company Limited of Pakistan planned to complete the project by 2020. The run-of-river hydroelectric power plant includes an underground powerhouse that will generate electricity from four 183-megawatt Francis turbine units. The powerhouse will be located in the province of Punjab, and the Karo Dam, a concrete gravity dam, will be built on the Jhelum River. All right, pitcher's got a noodle arm. I'm gonna get you. Oh, man. All right. This one's coming right back at you. Right back at you. Oh, you're horrible. Whoa.
Hey, Mr. Newscast guy. What are you doing?
I'm getting ready for the NHA in the 2-00-222 on the 2-7. Wait, that's too many twos.
You mean the National Hydropower Association's annual conference in Washington, D.C. on April 27th through the 29th?
Yep. The Mets are going to be there, and I'm trying to impress their scouts with my powerhouse skills. And...
What's that?
Us powerhouse types call this sludge. Most other people call it mashed up Tootsie Rolls.
Okay, first, ew. And second, Mets will be at the NHA conference, but no baseball scouts.
Oh, man. Okay, Rachel Campbell, marketing professional with Uber skills, please tell us worldwide what will be happening at the upcoming NHA conference?
Absolutely. The 2015 National Hydropower Association Conference will feature the inaugural International Marine Renewable Energy Conference. We call it MREC. And the third annual Marine Energy Technology Symposium. We hydrotypes call this METS. MREC covers the latest on U.S. and international marine energy. METS provides an opportunity to hear from experts on the latest wave and water current energy research that is pushing the pace of technological advancements. Co-locating MREC and METS with the National Hydropower Association Annual Conference is the opportunity for the full spectrum of hydro professionals to unify their voices and bring the latest issues to the table for discussion amongst industry experts, policymakers, and industry stakeholders.
All right, well, where can people learn more about information on the NHA Annual Conference where MREC and METS are going to be co-located for the first time?
Well, just go to www.marineenergytechnology.com.
Okay, well, you've heard that, and now that's it for this week's edition of the Worldwide Hydro Headlines. Make sure you check us out on Facebook, LinkedIn, and Twitter. And remember, we deliver hydro information at high capacity.